This video is brought to you by Cool Green Clothing. Cool Green Clothing is a Baltimore-based clothing line that started back in 2018 and has been growing strong ever since. Make sure you follow Cool Green Clothing on Facebook and IG at Cool Green Clothing and check out their website, coolgreenclothing.com, where you can find the latest Cool Green fashions and hats, women's apparel, and the latest men's collection. Remember, if you ain't cooling and getting the green,
because niggas be asking me like, yo, what cool green mean?
That's my name, man. When I first jumped off the porch, my man T, he got life right now, man. He named me AC Green. So what I did, I turned AC to cool, and you got cool green.
Yeah, Sean Lego, down here with my aunt, Cool Green, man. If you in Baltimore, stop downtown on Saratoga and holler at my app, man. Let them know when you down here, bro.
2610 West Saratoga Street, Thursday through Sunday. Holler at me.
Hey, big shout out to the bro with the team, Team AO. I ran into this guy. I just moved out here in Owens Mills. I just ran into somebody that got on the same thing I got on. Show him your hoodie real quick, bro. Y'all know what's up, man.
All right, nigga, the Maryland nigga, you know what time it is, man. You know what I'm saying? Cool green, man. Support black business, man. Yeah. Come on, yo.
Cool green all day, every day. Every day, look, nigga,
What's going on, YouTube fam? This your boy, Tony Two Times, and we back with another episode of The Baltimore Way, man. Y'all know what I need y'all to do. Be sure to like, comment, share the video. Watch the video to the end. This is a requested video from one of the fan members. Let's get right into it. Baltimore, Maryland, back in the 80s and 90s. A time in the city where it was a lot of activity, good and bad. A lot of money being made and a lot of dudes coming through the ranks. The city always bred different kind of people. You had your trappers, stick up kids, scammers that go day to day. Not much has changed, but the way people dress and the slang that's used. For this episode, we will take it back to what some like to call the golden era of Baltimore and talk about an individual family members referred to as Slick Al. Slick was born on 5/26/67 in Baltimore, Maryland. Growing up, Slick's parents wasn't together. His mother lived over west on EA and his father, who was a pastor, who had a house in the county and was part of a group called the Red Hats. Slick had four or five brothers and one sister coming up, with some of them having different mothers. Family alleged Slick really stayed to himself mostly and did his own thing. As he was growing up, becoming a young man, the temptations of the streets would soon come. With everybody trapping or finding a hustle, Slick would eventually try his hand at the trapper's lifestyle, but soon figured out that wasn't really his thing. In the 80s and 90s, the city was full of money and ways to make it. And Slick figured out trapping was cool, but robbing fit him much better. As a stick-up boy, you have to be on alert. Pay attention to who is making the money, people, places, and things. More important, make sure if you spot a target, the job is done right without too many mistakes that could cause you your freedom or your life. As Slick was transitioning into a new phase of his life, he took it seriously. On one occasion, allegedly almost robbing a family member as he hit the corner until he realized who it was. Sources say Slick would eventually migrate to East Baltimore and end up getting cool and being an associate of the infamous Baltimore kingpin, Anthony Jones, and his organization, linking with Baby Al over East. The two men became close. Slick Al would pick up the swag, as family say. He stayed fresh with the finest clothes, and he was a ladies' man. Favorite line being, "Let me take you to the moon." But in the streets, it was a whole nother story. Slick was known for going east to west, hitting licks, wherever the money was. Slick's only downfall, he liked to get high, which wasn't nothing new in the city at that time. Allegedly, Slick would study his victims, the way they moved, time they left the house, took out the trash, before eventually making his move. Even being cold enough to post on the same block after the job was done. Some say he would wear a trench coat with a pump underneath, but Slick would use the blicky as well. Allegedly, on one situation, hitting up a man through the window of a barbershop, where unfortunately he didn't make it. At the time, it was just part of the game. What stood out about Slick, he didn't have any pics, If you was showing money, he was coming. But as we all know, going hard and making enemies comes with its fair share of consequences. Family say Slick would eventually move in with an associate, and the man was in a wheelchair. But allegedly, Slick would always rob the man for whatever he wanted, until eventually the man got tired of being a victim. And allegedly one day, hitting Slick in the head. In April 1993, family said they used to talk and ask Slick's friends why they didn't talk to him about his ways and try to slow him down. But they said he responded, and they knew he was too far gone in the streets. R.I.P. Slick Al. Moral of this story, the life we choose definitely has consequences. It's an old saying, if you live by the gun, you die by the gun. It seemed like Slick made his mind up early and was dedicated to the streets. But some people are not. They really want better for themselves, but feel like they forced to live a certain way until it's too late. But hey, that's the Baltimore way. Man, salute to the person who gave me this story, you know. I supposed to Ben did this story, but he basically is a family member of Slick, the man who lost his life. And he was just saying, like, from what he heard, the way he was and the way he was carrying it in the streets, like, that's a dangerous lifestyle, because when you taking and you doing stuff and you getting away with it for so long, you get comfortable. And see, the person, you know, who took his life, unfortunately, the guy in the wheelchair, he probably wasn't even thinking he'd do nothing like that. You know, you never underestimate people out here, because you never know what the next person going through, and never say what a person won't do. But when you living like that, some people don't care. Like I say, some people don't got picks. They feel like, if you got it and I want it, I'ma take it. And some people okay with them consequences. But then on the other hand, you got people out here living like that, that feel like they gotta live like that, or feel like it's cool to live like that. But then when the rabbit got the gun, you know, they feeling some kind of way, or they really don't want to leave here, or they really don't want nothing bad to happen to them. So, you know, that's double-minded. You can't be double-minded. You got to be real with yourself more than anybody. You know what I mean? You can't prove nothing to the street. You got to prove it to yourself. But yeah, man, definitely a good episode, man. Be sure to like, comment, share. Y'all already know I appreciate the love and support. Let me know who y'all want to see next, man. We definitely grinding. You feel me? We on that road to 50K. So be sure to hit that like button, fam. I got a giveaway coming real soon. You feel me? I'm just waiting for the right time. I'm going to be going live with y'all. Got some new segments coming. So stay tuned. You feel me? Like I said, y'all can email me at tony2times.biz@gmail.com or follow me on Instagram @_tony2times. I love y'all, fam. RIP Slick Al. I'm out.